Now, the buyers of your product are going to form your community, right? Now, you know, you call them whatever you want to. You call them your list, you call them your subscribers. I like to call them the community. And so these are going to be the people that you want to be talking to, right? You got to find out from them what else they need and want for you to solve. Now, don't ask them what product should I create, because that may or may not give you the answer that you really want. You have to figure out what problem they're really having inside of your niche, because you want to take the problem that's most significant to the most people and solve those problems in order. So in other words, whatever is the most pressing problem to the most people in your community, solve that problem. That's your next product. Right now, find out what they'd like to solve. Right, find out what they'd like to solve. So what you want to do is, even if one person answers, right? Let's say that you put out an email. Let's say you've got 10 people on your list. One person responds, right? With these little short products where you're solving problems, just solve that problem, right? And launch the product on Warrior Plus. I don't care if you only get 2 or 3 sales, and you'll see how that's not even the point, right? So the product snowball kind of works because you continue to build this community of people who have bought your products. More than likely, right? More than likely, if you sell something, you might get maybe a 20 to 30% retention of people if you're solving the problems in your community of people who have already bought your products. Does that make sense? So in other words, here's some people who've already bought your products. And then you're going to go to them, you're going to say, you're going to massage the question a little bit. You're going to ask it in a lot of different ways. And you're going to find out what problem they want solved, and you're going to solve that problem with a product, right? You will probably be able to get, if you're good at that, you'll be able to get, I'd say, 20-30% of the people who have already bought your first product. So let's see, Rogelio, you're asking, can I use the PLR through a membership site or just use the thank you page what comes with the PLR? That's actually a great question. What I would say is that there are a couple ways to look at that. If you're going to use a membership script, you just want to make sure that it's going to be easy for you to be able to whip products out quickly, right? Because if you can't do it quickly, I will tell you from experience that a complicated membership site is the difference between launching a product and not launching it sometimes. You will walk away from your desk and not come back to it if something's complicated for you. Right, and sometimes you even have to sacrifice the fact that your page might be in the open. Right, you might say, well, man, that, you know, I don't, my page isn't totally secure, and you know, I'd rather have it locked up. In this particular case, when you're trying to do a product snowball, I'm almost going to say that getting it out, getting it done, getting it launched is more important than locking it up in a complicated system that you can't operate quickly. For the life of me, I can tell you that's true. It is for real. A membership site can someday, every membership software has some limitations. It also doesn't do everything you want it to do. I don't care which one you own. I don't care what system you have. There's no membership site that's going to do 100% of what you want done 100% of the time. And so what happens is we want the membership site to do something. It doesn't do it, and then we go hunting. How many of you all have had the experience of trying to hunt down and reading forums to try to figure out how a membership script works? Right. And so sometimes, if you've ever had that experience before, that'll keep you from launching sometimes. And so you think, well, I didn't get this launched because I didn't get it locked up. And then what happens is 2 or 3 weeks later, I promise you, you'll look back and you'll say, maybe I should have just launched it anyway, right? And so find out what they want to solve. Continue to create new product solving problems. The product snowball means that you're launching these products based on what your community tells you. And every time you launch a new product, your community grows. So in other words, you're going to get new buyers every time you go and you launch product. Now again, you might be able to get some affiliates even if you don't know anybody, right? You're going to get new buyers. And I can't promise that naturally. I can't promise you're going to get new buyers. And I don't want to go on recording promising you're going to get new buyers if you do what I tell you to do. But generally, you can get a new buyer. You can get new buyers if you continually solving real problems that you know are in the market, that you are going to the marketplace with a product that specifically addresses that problem. Right now, when you get a little bitty community, right, start promoting relevant affiliates. So in other words, don't go promoting everybody. Find the affiliates in your particular niche that you want to promote their products or services, right? In general, right? I don't know how faithful I am to this. I really try hard to find people who have business PLR. Somebody approached me about promoting a software program that had reseller rights. And in the past, I've done that kind of thing. I chose not to do that because I'm really trying to not get outside of what I feel like my expertise is, right? And even if I give up not necessarily making the commission on that, I don't particularly care about that. I want people who are going to be relevant to what I'm trying to do in my own business, and you need to do the same thing, right? You would say you are building a brand as an HTML specialist, right? Then don't listen. You should not be promoting WordPress stuff, right? You should not be talking about WordPress. I'm not saying that you can't. I'm not saying that you won't make sales. I'm saying that if you are focusing on solving the problems of people who have HTML, focus on that, right? Don't go finding people who have products that talk about WordPress. Or even PLR. Let's say you know, well, here's a guy with a PLR program. So what, right? So what if they come and ask you? So what if this is your friend? So what, right? The point is, are you serving your community? And you can serve your community better when they know what to expect from you, right? And ultimately, I honestly think you will make more money that way. Now, again, I know that I'm counter to other people when I come to that, but I honestly believe that in the long run, you'll make more cash by giving people an expectation. Well, you know what? I know if I open Charles' email, it's going to be talking about this one thing. And I know if I open up this guy's email, I know he's going to be talking about this one thing. You need to be the man or the woman that talks about, I don't know, whatever it is, right? And if I know that every time I open up your email, I know what to expect, then I'm not going to be offended when you do an affiliate promotion, right? Now, so promote relevant affiliates. Start developing relationships with those affiliates, right? Develop relationships with them. That might mean, you know, finding, you know, going to these conferences where they're going to be. It might mean talking to them on social media. Now, I'm not the best at that, so I can't say that I do. I'm great at that. But develop affiliate relationships, right? Develop them. And however you do it, right? Everybody here has a way they develop affiliate relationships. I'm going to say you do that by any means necessary. So if you need to get to a conference, if you can go to it, I don't know if your niche is going to be there. I don't know if the affiliates in your niche are going to be there. But if they are, then I would say that going there and shaking their hands is going to help you. I would say that going there and shaking their hands, meeting them in person, going to lunch with them, or going to dinner with them, then that's going to ultimately help you when you go and you approach them and you say to them, hey, you know what, I've got something really cool that's coming out, and then they know you. Right, I cannot explain what happens to you, but I can tell you from experience that every time I've actually gone to one of these internet marketing conferences with people who are in our, right, who are in our market. Now, I'm talking about people who are in the information marketing niche. I'm talking about us, right? I'm talking about conferences where we are. If I go to conferences where we are, there has not been one time where I have not been benefited. And so again, it matters. Yeah, and $200 for a conference and one day off your job could make the difference in your online income. Start asking them for their support. And so that's going to be the hard part. In some cases, if you've already promoted somebody, then it's going to be a little easier to ask them for their support, right? But try to promote them first, right? Try to go out of your way to find an excuse to promote their product first before you go and request their support. Try to meet them in person first. Now, again, that's not always going to be possible. Try to have some conversation with them before you request their support. Now, all this stuff comes before you start looking for affiliates. Right now, I know how important affiliates are. Does everybody see how long this list is? What comes before you start asking affiliates for their stuff, for their support? All these other things come first. And again, getting affiliates on your side, it isn't necessarily. I'd say it's not the easiest thing in the world to do, and I don't even know how good I am at it. But I can say it can be done. You don't have to be. You don't have to be a member of the club. It's not personal with most people. People want to know, an affiliate wants to know, number one, are they going to serve their community best by sending out your link? Number two, they want to be able to make money, right? Nobody wants to send out your link and then not make money and waste a mailing because your product may not be up to snuff, right? So again, request their support at this point. And then this is not always going to work, but it does work sometimes. And I've done this in the past, and I'd say I've been turned down more often than not than I've asked to do this. You can take your most awesome product, make it a bonus, and then approach an affiliate and say, hey, you know what? Can I offer this as a bonus on your download page? Go to the affiliate early enough so that they can put it in their sales copy, right? And that's important because otherwise – it doesn't do me any good for me to put you on my download page. But if you come to me early, right, and you say, excuse me, I noticed that you're launching a product on product launches. I have a product launch software, and I'd like to offer it as a bonus. Now, that would be really cool for me to be able to add on my sales page and as part of my sales copy. And then it's a win-win situation. Number one, I have it as a bonus. Number two, you then have it. You get to put your bonus on my download page and collect the leads, right? So put your most awesome bonus on affiliate's download page. It's just really easy, and this is something that, again, it's not going to be the complicated things that we do that will make the most money. It really is these really simple things that we have to take. The unglamorous steps, I'll say, right? None of this is sexy, right? None of this is glamorous. And that's the problem with it. We're just not all going to all come to this being able to sell like that, right? We're not gonna all going to be Dan Kennedy sales writers. But with the product snowball, you know what it takes? It takes consistency. It takes the same consistency that you probably have when you get up every morning, you set your alarm for 6 o'clock, and you get up and you go to work. That's the kind of person that can do a product snowball. Product snowball is the kind of person that can go to work every day, ignore the people that get on their nerve, ignore whatever the traffic, do their job, come back home, go back and do it again. That's the kind of person that excels at this. And so this is really for the normal person. You don't have to be a super salesperson. Internet marketing is basically being prolific. It's not that you have a seven-figure product launch, right? It's that you are consistently delivering value, and what happens is, just like I said the last week, eventually something takes off, right? You keep throwing the jab with your left hand, and at some point you get an opening to throw your right hand. Okay, now, let's see. Damon said, you can put bumpers on your PLR videos instead of doing them all, correct? Yeah, I think so. And so that's really the kind of thing that you want to pick up something that's got some quality. You want to pick up something that when you walk away, you know that your base, they're going to be getting something that you don't have to go back and watch it over, right? You don't want to get something that you got to watch it over to see what somebody else says. And I would say that's going to be the case with Steve. Okay, so Rogelio's question is, how can I flip a PLR and make it unique that a PLR junkie doesn't recognize it? That's really a great point. Number one, I think, Rogelio, you have to lead with the problem, right? Because in other words, let's say that you're going to lead with solving the problem. So eventually, the voice I'm going to hear should be yours. You're not, when you are flipping a PLR, What you're adding unique is you're going to solve a specific problem. What's the problem you could solve? You could solve a problem with somebody who needs to learn how to build an email marketing list. What are you going to lead with? So what's the title of your product? The rest of your product is going to be how to build a list, right? It's not going to be how to learn AWeber. So you're going to say, I'm going to give people the opportunity to learn AWeber, but the problem I'm solving is how to build a list. So you lead with the problem, right? You lead by solving the problem, and the PLR becomes the raw material. I don't necessarily like the term flip. I know it's used. I know we use it a lot as internet marketers. I don't particularly like it because I just think that if you can put a little bit of effort into it and you do the research to figure out what people really want to know, you do the process in the reverse order. So in other words, the point isn't how do I get the PLR to meet the marketplace? It's, okay, I've determined what the marketplace wants. Now, where can I go in my inventory of PLR to find something that will help me to meet the marketplace?